Hi, I didn't see you there. My name is Katarzyna and I am your host in today's episode of How Does It Roll? Today I will tell you about RIM profiles. There are a few of them available and they deserve more recognition than they receive. I will show you the production process behind the RIM profiles and I will explain what is their purpose or maybe how do they roll. Okay, roll the intro. As my colleagues explained in the previous episodes of our series, wheels most commonly consist of two parts, a rim and a disc. We produce rims entirely by ourselves. Our machine park allows us to shape those round elements out of sheets of metal. Our rim production line consists of four profiling machines, where the element reaches the required shape and one of the rim profiles. But where do those norms come from? Each continent has its own technical organization whose task is to collect production standards for countries in a given region. For example, wheels and tires for European market are made according to the ETRTO norms and same products for Japanese market are made according to the JATMA standards. In all those publications, there is a chapter dedicated to agriculture where you can find the rim profiles we talk about in this episode. The wheel you can see here has W profile. On this flat surface, right there, the tire bead is located. The outer rim flange protects the tire from slipping out of its place. It is also known as a brake corner. By examining this part of the rim, we decide if the rim has W, DW profile or some other. Those two are most common in agricultural wheels. This one is definitely a W. W characterizes by having a step in this area. To get a better view, let's see it in the studio. So this is a rim with W profile. W stands for well, but it is a less known name for it, so we just call it W. The W is a step between two flat surfaces, the middle of the rim and the bead. This is a DW profile. In general, it is a double W, as you can see on the wheel itself. It has two steps instead of one. But there are much more differences between W and DW. Okay, but what's the point of rim profiles? There are two main reasons why they were introduced. The first reason is the simplification of tire mounting process. The flange makes it impossible for the tire to be taken off or mounted on without damaging it. Rim profiles simplify tire mounting process by adding the additional step to the rim base. It allows us to put the tire bead in the lowest point of the rim just to put on the tire on the other side of the rim. Of course, there is a bit of strength needed to get the tire bead through the W step, but it is way easier with the W profile than without it. While W profile is used in wheels in sizes from 6 inches, the DW profile is introduced to rims in sizes from around 20 inches. The DW profile is used when machine the wheel is made for requires additional durability. Why? Tires made for such machines are bigger, heavier and stiffer and getting the tire bead through one step requires a lot of force. Two steps simplify the process of tire mounting and this is why DW is used in machines designed for the toughest jobs. There is one more profile I didn't mention, H2. H is short for hump and rims with H2 profile have two humps. It's that simple. Humps were introduced to eliminate the problem of tires slipping off when turning the wheels in heavy machines. In this case, the tire bead is located between two humps to stiffen the tire in its place. H2 profile is most commonly used in implement wheels made for heavy trailers, forestry and industrial machines. They especially come in handy when we decide to use heavy steel belted tires. Two humps hold the tire bit in its place when trailer without turning axles turns while driving. Operation like that can cause the tire to slip from their place when we use wheel without H2 profile. Such wheels can be also made with additional knurling. This inconspicuous pattern of lines is present on the wheel under the tire bit. It limits the tire slippage under heavy loads. What's more, H2 wheels can be also produced with reinforced rod welded close to the flange. This enhancement increases wheel's endurance, making it less prone to deformation. There is one more question left. Which rim profile is the best? There is no right answer. Usually the choice of the wheel is based on the application and tire. That's why such choices are left for professionals. That's it for today. If you have any more questions, do not hesitate to contact us. See you next time!
Pronar Wheels. We drive your business.